We will learn about phase 3 studies. We already covered the basics, right? Phase 1, phase 2, phase 3 studies. Now these phase 3 studies, they are also known as a therapeutic confirmatory, because in phase 1, you remember, these studies are done for a safety. We just take care of like if the product is really safe. That is phase 1. Phase 2 is exploratory, where you are exploring little more but on a very smaller population. Now you have to confirm that this drug has really therapeutic value, right? It is showing effects. So that's why this is known as a therapeutic confirmatory phase. Whenever someone asks you in phase 3 studies, what are the phase 3 studies, tell them these are therapeutic confirmatory studies. Now let's see what are the key points of these studies. So these are of course done in thousands of patients. Mostly you can say maybe 3,000, 4,000. This number can go up to maybe a 20,000. So number of patient depends on totally study design, but they are large population in thousands. The patients are thousands. In phase 2, they are in the hundreds, very little population, but here the population size is quite high. And the patient who are having actual disease and indication, they are involved, because you wanted to see if this new treatment is really working or not. Now, what you see in this treatment, like in this phase, is that how much this new treatment is showing effect. Is it showing its effect by 50%, 60%, 70%? How much it is helping patient in terms of disease, right? And it also simultaneously, you know, monitors these adverse event, because now your population is higher. It is in thousands. In phase 2, they are just in hundreds. So maybe the side effect, those are not being noticed earlier in the small population, they can come up now. So they really see what are the side effect. Length of the study, mostly 1 to 4 years. So length of study is also longer. So that is also one of the reasons you will be able to monitor the side effect more closely. Now, additional factor which is looked into these studies, which is the highlight of these studies, they are compared with the standard treatment. If that treatment is already in the market, already available in the market, maybe there is some way that symptoms of those disease are taken care of, right? So now this new treatment is compared with standard treatment. So this is how they will be able to come to know that shall they really launch the new treatment. If it is better than the standard treatment in any way, then only they will be able to launch this new treatment. So these are the key highlights of phase 3 studies. Now let's see how effective these phase 3 studies are. What is success rate? Success rate is around 20 to 30% only. Again, attrition rate is very high. If the drug is safe in phase 3, then new drug application can be filed. In our next video, we will study that how this new drug
Thanks for watching. Turn on the notifications and do subscribe Rise and Shine channel for getting such valuable contents.